Hi, we are
NoonaTalk.
I'm Zara.
And I'm Sophia. And today we are reacting to
Cotton Candy by Jinyoung. Okay, but like, be very honest with me. Did you think that that was the name of the title track? Because I 100% thought that the name of the title track was the same name as the album.
What is the album called?
With.
Full disclosure, I had no idea about any of this. Like, I just found out it's called Cotton Candy because you said it right now.
Oh, no, really? That's crazy. Okay. No, I've been, like, keeping an eye. And yeah. I, until maybe 2 days ago, was very convinced that the title track was also called Win. I don't know why.
But yeah, so this is, I think Jinyoung is the only person who hasn't released a solo album in GoT7, right? Like, ever since
this is his first.
Yeah, ever since their contract ended. I think JB has already put out like three different names. I wanna know everything all about you.
You know, you're a 긴장감. This shirt though, oh my god, chicken chic.
I love this look with the metallic jacket inside.
Shirt, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, sure. It's 70s party chic.
Yeah. Are we in the 70s? Or is this like a... It could be.
What's happening? I feel like I don't understand story.
Yeah. Is this like in different times?
This is why we need translations.
I don't think the translations would tell us these things.
That is true. And also, what is this like amorphous cloud that's there in some
scenes? Like that TikTok thing where you put cotton to make that lamp.
Sure, sure. But like, it's not always there. Is he dead? Why is that such a common like K-pop MV reaction for us? Where, like, everything dead. It is giving very British. But like, I don't know.
Like Doctor Who in love in uni.
I know vocalizing is such a bare minimum thing, but in this song, it adds such a beautiful fluidity. Fluidity.
We get it. It's fine. I know, whistle tone below the like the vocalizer.
Yeah, so if you like just see just now, see he's whistling.
Oh. Cotton candy, 왜 이제
왔니? Sweet cotton. Okay, this is a set from What a Man Gotta Do, Jonas Brothers. I know this. It is. Oh. It's from Happiness Begins. I genuinely really liked it.
Yeah, it was so, like, yeah, fluid is the word. It was just like, you know.
Yeah, it did like this thing.
Car, the windows down.
Yeah, it's road trip music.
Yeah, it is road trip music. Just very, like, easy listening. Bedroom.
But that's what I was going to say. That's what I was going to say, that they've tricked you into thinking it's easy listening, but it absolutely isn't with the amount of layers of, like, vocals that they've got going on. And also, no, like, in terms of instrument
wise, I mean, like, it's easy to listen to.
Oh, I genuinely meant genre wise that they have. Oh. It feels like they're pushing, hey, cash listening, easy listening.
And then there's a lot of things.
Yeah, especially with that incredible bass line that's super R&B.
Yeah, it is. It's bedroom pop, I think, does have a lot of R&B influences. And it's got this, especially I think I love the part from the bridge to the ending, because it just added like a couple of more elements in the harmonies and everything, but it really worked. It was very, very nice, very chill. Also, Jinyoung is like, He's such a quintessential K-drama hero. Look, like, why are you like, wearing turtlenecks, bro? Like, please.
Yeah, it makes, like, why are you wearing a long coat in this random 70s British era looking place? Like, what's happening?
Why is there a telephone booth? That's why it's giving Doctor Who to me. Like, that's the only reason.
No, it's all, I think it's just, like, everything looks brown and, like, cloudy. That's very British.
Telephone booth.
Okay.
Red telephone booth.
It reminded me of like a set from like Sex Education.
True. That is true. Especially the school college vibe also was there.
Yeah. I feel like I definitely
the therapy session part though.
I don't think I understood any of it, and a lot of that has to do with the fact that like we just don't know what the lyrics are.
I don't think the lyrics would have changed.
Maybe, okay, maybe we're not like Agassi is enough to know. Maybe there's some lore behind this. If you are an Agassi, please comment down below and let us know if maybe we just don't have the depth of knowledge to understand this MV. However, musically...
And link us to a lyric translation. Like, what is this behavior?
Yeah. But musically, I will say that this was maybe one of like my... second favorite GoT7 debuts. No, third. Okay.
Oh, really?
Third.
What was the second?
Bam Bam's Ribbon.
In fact, this gave me a lot of Ribbon vibes. Like, Ribbon was a lot more bright.
Fun,
and
yeah.
This it was a very reeled back, more R&B. Like, Ribbon didn't have the R&B vibes. It was more pop, which is very... like, hip-hop pop. But this was... but in the same
this
sphere,
was more mellow.
This is more mellow, but kind of in the same like.
I guess. But I feel like if Ribbon hadn't happened, then this would have edged it out. I feel like I do need a couple of other listens to just maybe like decide how I feel about
the album. But I think it does a good job being a title track, making you want to check out the album. I think that is important.
That is very true. I genuinely went into this with like no expectations.
No idea. I was, because most... I just associate Jinyoung with ballads.
Like, because he's an incredible vocal artist. So that's sort of what I thought this would be. Like something like a Paul Kim. But did you like our reaction to Jinyoung's Cotton Candy? Let us know in the comments below.
And tell us what's your favorite song on the album.
And what else we should listen to from the album. Yeah, definitely. We do reactions like this fairly often. So let us know if there is anything that you would like us to react to. Along with that, you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel for our weekly podcast episodes where we talk about K-pop, K-drama, K-culture, anything else. Especially if you're a Desi stan. And you can also follow us on Instagram at NoonaTalk, exactly like it sounds, for all the other content that we create. We will see you soon with another reaction or episode. Bye.
Bye. Like